Hi, this is Mike Sayers from Mechanical Simulation. This video is going to explain what paths are and how we use them in our math models in Car Sim, Truck Sim, and Bike Sim. So here's a view from the Car Sim website that's talking about VS reference paths, which is what we use here. It is a continuous line that is in the horizontal plane with no sharp corners in it. We use it to define a coordinate system which has S, the distance along the path, and a lateral coordinate L, which is the distance from the path perpendicular. Why do we use these? For several reasons. One, we give them to the driver and, if it's bike sim, rider models, and they can try to minimize the L coordinate as they go along the path. We use it for moving objects to do the same kinds of things, and sometimes we use them to define road properties such as elevation, rolling resistance, and tire friction. So back to our example here, we see the path that's being used by the driver model shown with the dashed blue line. We have a second path that is used to define the road, and that's the left edge of the pavement here. So let's take a look in the database here to see where those paths are defined. Here are road properties, and we have the reference path here that is the left edge of the pavement. It's a bunch of XY coordinates that were taken from GPS data in this example. There's a second one, which is the input for the driver, and it looks to be about the same. It's a bunch of global XY coordinates that come in from someplace else. In this case, we had a staff member, Phil Mather, who was an experienced racer, drive a simulator at low speed and record the XY coordinates to get the data for this table. So how do these paths get used in the driver controls? Well, the last path is used as an input for the steer control if we use that. And for the speed, it's looking at acceleration limits. It's going to preview along the path and go as fast as it can, up to 200 kilometers per hour, but it will not exceed 1.7, 1.8 Gs in the left, right, braking, and accelerating directions. So we'll look at the run one more time, and we see that we're going along here. Up, our speed is shown as a function of station. We have the driver model following the little turquoise sphere there, following the racer path. We have the plot on the lower right, the acceleration versus acceleration. We also have a G per G meter in here that is showing the speed controller is doing what it can, going as fast as it can, while taking into account the lateral and also the vertical curvature of the road to maintain those prescribed limits. Every simulation has a path, even something as simple as our introductory quick start guide double lane change here. We see a lot of plots over here that are functions of time, but the main one is a function of station. It's a lateral distance to the path. We have a blue line that is a target. The red line is what the car achieves. When we look at the procedure for this, we go into the steering controls and we see that this deviation from the straight line path is what the driver model is trying to follow. That's LTARG. We can have up to 500 paths in a simulation, and we can have up to 500 LTARG data sets. We always specify the initial location using station along the driver path. We might also specify the stop time, or as a stop distance using station. In this case, we're going to stop at S equals 210. Now here's a case where we're using a path for our driver model. We're using a bunch of paths with a bunch of road segments to make this roundabout intersection, and we're using more paths to identify or to locate traffic vehicles that are in here. Let's take a look at how that's set up. In the echo file, you can see that there are 10 paths here that are installed. We'll look at a screen we haven't seen before, the path segment builder. In this, we can build up a path using segments which are straight lines, constant radius, clothoid, and a few other instances. This is the case for our vehicle coming in, going in a straight line, making a turn to the right, going in the roundabout, and then exiting. We can also build paths as part of our tool, the VS Scene Builder. This can be used to construct scenes by dragging tiles from a repository, bringing them in the workspace here. They snap into place. We can build paths. We see that there are three that were made already. I can make them left-handed or right-handed, depending on whether it's US convention or Japan convention. If I want to add one, I click the button to add it, and I can go in and see these little yellow triangles. Wherever there's a triangle, I can click on it and it activates the next one. Here now I've got two options. I can go straight or I can turn to the left. I'll go straight. Now I've got a new path in here that I can bring into CarSim. We have a library screen in CarSim that is called the Scene External Import. We can bring things in from various sources, including the Scene Builder. So we go up here and click the Import button, go into Scene Builder, and this is a data set that was saved for export from the data set we just looked at in Scene Builder. It has the three paths that were already in there. One goes to the right, one comes from the other direction, goes to the right, one goes straight through. We have the Ego vehicle here going towards the intersection. There's a pedestrian waiting here, bicyclist coming, one turns to the right, one goes straight. Our Ego vehicle is going to turn to the right. So we have the three paths all being used here, one to control the driver, one can control the bicycle, and one to control the other bicycle. So we've now seen what paths are, how they're created, and how they're used in some of our examples. Thank you for watching.